If you're collecting an Astra Militarum army, then it's more than likely you're going to have some tanks. So it's a good idea to know how to paint the camouflage. Now in this video, I'm going to show you how to paint the Cadian camo scheme using the new Hydra kit. But of course, you could use this for any Militarum tank. So let's get started. So the very first thing that we need to do is base coat the entire tank and the turret with a good base coat of green, and the ideal one for Cadian vehicles is Castellan green. So like always, got to give the paint a good shake, and the brush that I'm going to be using for this is a large dry brush, which is, well, the biggest brush I've got here, and that's because there's just so much of the vehicle to cover. So what I do is get a bit of the paint, pop it on the palette like this, and this will allow me to control how much paint is in the bristles, because it's important that you don't put too much paint on, because if you do, you can start clogging the detail. Now this bit's very straightforward. All you got to do is start painting this green on the vehicle and work it into all the little details like this. Now you might find that the paint doesn't cover entirely in one coat, and that's absolutely fine. Just let it dry and apply another coat later, because having multiple thin layers is always better than one thick layer. Now if you need to water the paint down at all, I recommend that you don't do it with this brush, and that's because it absorbs water very quickly, so it can be hard to control how much water you're mixing in. So instead, do the mixing with a large brush or a standard brush, they should be fine. Now it can't have escaped your notice as well that I've not actually glued the tracks onto this, and that's a common thing I do with all tanks, because it's much easier to paint the track links when they're still on the sprue. Now that I've finished base coating the green, we're ready to move on to the next stage, and that is to start marking out where all the camo lines are going to go. So for this, you're going to need Zandri dust, and we're going to be using the same large dry brush that we used before. So as always, I'm going to get some paint and put it on the palette like this, and I'm going to be using the palette here to get the brush into, well, to be quite narrow, I'm looking for quite a chisel point to it. So you're looking to get it like that. And this stage, well, this stage is very messy, you just need to find a good starting point like down here, and just start very roughly painting on where the line is going to go. So be fairly random with it, because these lines, they do sort of wiggle all the way over the vehicle. But this point here, this line, is an ideal one to start with, because this will run over the entire length of the vehicle, like this, you see? So once this one's on, I can use it to gauge where all the other camo lines need to go. So there we go, so it goes on like that. So you see with that line running across it there, I can gauge where all the other ones are going to be. Now you're looking to cover around about a third of the vehicle with these markings, and there is of course the turret as well. So when you come to do that, just place the turret on like that and put it into its default position, so facing straight forward like that. And when it's in that position, your camo line should run across it in an unbroken manner. So it's going to run across the turret kind of like that. So what I'm going to do now is carry on just roughly putting in these markings, and then we can neaten them up. There, so now that I've finished painting on the Zandri dust quite roughly, I can see where all those camo lines are going to run, which makes this next stage much easier, because now we need to neaten those lines up. So the colour is again Zandri dust, but this time I'm going to be using a large brush, and I'm going to be using my palette to allow me to thin the paint down with just a small amount of water. You don't need very much at all. So mix that in there. And then I've got this little trick that I like to do, where I like to drag my brush along like that and twist it, because this gets rid of any excess paint and also allows me to get a nice fine tip on my brush like that. And what you've got to do now is work around all of these camo markings that you've marked in and work around the edges of them like this, so that you can neaten up those edges and get nice smooth curved lines like this. Now that I've finished kneading up the Zandri dust, I need to do exactly the same thing really, but this time it's with Castellan green. So I'm using the large brush again, and I've also got a standard brush because some of these areas are quite small, so that'll be useful to keep neat. And what we do is just thin down the paint in exactly the same way, and as I say, it's the same kind of process. You're looking for anywhere on the tank where the Zandri dust is a bit messy, and just neaten it up like this, and you're looking to get that line between the two colours to be as smooth as possible. Now that I've finished the Castellan green, the camo pattern's nicely base coated in, and the next stage is to start shading it. So for this, you're going to need Agrax Earthshade, and the brush I'm going to use is a detail brush, because, well, this part is quite precise, so you need a fine brush for it. And what you do is start painting this carefully into all the little recesses between the panels, so like this one here, for example. And this includes all the rivets and, well, just about any bit of detail like this. And so this will take a little while, but it's really going to define all that detail for you. Now that I've finished the shade on the model, you can see it's making all those details really pop out. And the next stage is to apply some highlights to the model. And to do this, we're going to be dry brushing it. Now there are three colours for this. Okay, the first one is Lorem Forest, and that's going to be on all the green areas. Then it's Shabti Bone, which is going on all the Zandri Dust areas. And finally, there's Terminator Stone, which is going across the whole model. Now the application is going to be the same for all three, but I'll show you in detail how to do it with Lorem Forest. So what you do is get your large dry brush and make sure it's completely bone dry before you do this, otherwise you can leave quite a streaky mess in the model. But when it's dry, just get a little bit of paint on the end of the brush like that and get some tissue and use it to start working that paint in amongst all the bristles like this. Now this gets rid of any excess paint on your brush because you don't need very much. In fact, having a brush like that is ideal. So what you do, grab your model and angle your brush so you're using the narrower edge like this and just start lightly flicking it back and forth across the tank like this, but keep it to the green areas and you'll see that green paint will start picking out all those raised surfaces. So what you need to do is work around your model like this, dry brushing only on the green areas, and it is possible that you'll get some on the Zandri dust, and if you do, don't worry about it, just switch back to the Zandri dust and neaten it up. And then repeat this process on the Zandri dust areas using a Shabti bone, and again, be as neat as possible. And finally, do a very light dry brush of Terminator Stone across the entire model. Now doing this binds all the colours together, but you must make sure that you're very gentle with it and you have hardly any paint on your brush. So there you go, that's how you paint Cadian camo. And after this, you'll then move on to painting all the details on your model. So just to recap, when you're doing this colour scheme, start out by painting the whole model green first of all. After that, roughly mark in where the camo lines are going to go, and then neaten them up afterwards. Now once you've done that, shade both the colours at the same time, and then use dry brushing to highlight them. But that's how you paint the Cadian camouflage scheme, so remember, you can use this technique for painting any Cadian vehicle.